Hey there you, welcome back to another video. This is a pick a card reading video, a pick a card reading. This is going to be reading number one. And then afterwards, you can keep letting it roll and watch reading number two if you want, whatever you're inspired to do. Now look, if you're picking the reading number one, set the intention that this is for you, that the information that comes through is divinely timed, meaning that everything happens at the right time and you're always in the right place. If you make this intention, then you can relax and take it easy. Then you can just let the information roll through and see how it plays on your beliefs, on the things you're going through, on the things you've been through, on your emotions and whatnot. Now look, in order to get started, we're just about to get ready for pile number one, pick a reading number one. Take a deep breath, hold it in a little bit extra long, because this will flood our blood with oxygen. Deep breathing helps to calm our emotions and open our mind so that we are more susceptible to hearing in new ways, to thinking creatively, metaphorically, symbolically. And this will allow us to make new connections with the information coming through the reading. So here we go, reading number one. Watch it all the way through and just relax, let it roll over you. You can always rewatch it a second time and take notes if you feel like you need to do that. The first card that comes up for reading number one is, boom, the music healing card. Now, what's this about? This is about letting go of our words. When we're talking about music, we're talking about melody. We're talking about movement. We're talking about flow. So it's a season of letting go of thinking, letting go of figuring stuff out, and being more in the moment where we're just in that gentle little bit of flow. Allow the music of life to be our friend, our little helper, the thing that's going through our voice. Feel the feelings, the vibrations of your own voice when you're communicating with other people. And you can do this best when you get into this green heart chakra, you can see it on her sleeve, and you relax with a mindful conscious breathing exercises, with a little bit more of a bringing yourself back to center throughout the day over and over. One way to do that is to put up some sticky notes that just say center. And then you're able to just remember to go back into that quiet inner space where the song and the vibration emerges from. Now, the other thing we see here is that all of this, you can see all of the spiral going around with the music. This is showing us that music or vibration or emotion expands us in all directions. So this is opposite of using our words to really define things, to really get rigid and structured. It's asking us to be loose and relaxed. Let's take a look at card number two in this reading. So we know that healing really is just renewal. It's not necessarily that we're ill and that we need to be healed. No, it's more like, I want expansion. I want new inspiration. I want a new feeling of vitality and expanded experience. And that's all going to come by connecting with the emotion, the gentle flow of the light that moves through us, as opposed to the divine masculine words. So take a look at card number two, and it's called the Fool. Now look, it doesn't mean we're foolish, doesn't mean we're silly. No, this simply means that we're going to take that leap to expand. You can see it all happening here with the way that the musical notes are going in every direction. That's getting us off of the divine masculine and taking a risk off of what we've always known to be safe and true. We're going to let go of knowing, let go of defining, let go of having things being figured out, and instead just get into this orange, yellow, and red. Those are the chakras for creativity, for expansion, for joy of living. Take some risks as that green heart chakra. You can see it now on his legs. We saw it over here on her arms. That is the divine feminine bringing in the light. And you can see it on his legs. The divine masculine is following that tune, is putting his voice down, putting his words down, and allowing for taking a risk on your gut, taking a risk on your subtle feelings, on your subtle tune, and your subtle flow. This is going to bring a whole new depth of empowerment where you really feel again like a child that is put into the world, but not dumb or ignorant or anything like that, not unskilled, no. A childlike mindset where you're able to be aware of the subtleties of the shifts of the emotions that are happening. Surrender to listening to your body, to the wonder and the wisdom of your body. Now, this is going to be that experience where you're just going to get what we're talking about with that gut feeling. I just sort of know. I just sort of sense I should go in this direction. It is beyond logic, beyond words, beyond all of what we used to do or what other people tell us to do, beyond all of our past experiences. We are in a renewed state of being in the subtle, sensitive place of feeling our feelings and listening to our body, following suit. If you feel tired, sleep. If you're hungry, eat. If you feel that you ought to go in this direction or that, go ahead and follow. Allow the wisdom of your body as a channel of light, as a musical instrument, your body as a musical instrument to lead you. Let's take a look at the next card in this reading. Continue to watch it to the end. There's at least two more cards coming out. After this, you can always rewatch it and consider it, or you can move on to reading number two. So we are in this phase where we're letting go of the divine masculine, our words. We're not thinking that much. We're just relaxing. We are taking more risks on our gut feelings and listening to our body. We're allowing that integration of our body and our heart and our mind so that we are following through on this beautiful experience. Now persist in this practice so that you can get all of those rich yellow, reds, and oranges, as you can see that he was taking a leap out. When we let go of what we knew in favor of what we could know, there's a little bit of a strange space where the music, maybe we don't know the tune, it feels unfamiliar, this can feel uncomfortable, this can feel strange. But relax, take those breaths, come back to the center when you feel that way, and know that you are making a leap of faith until this tree gets solid planted. You're gonna find the wisdom of your heart mind, as you can see by the purple heart here, which is the crown chakra, and you're gonna see a new autumn of all of these beautiful creative experiences that are coming through if you persist. So this is about continuing to follow your gut, even if it looks like, you know, maybe I should go back to what was familiar. Don't do it. Take the chance to expand and grow. Get off of the skinny branches, get out onto the faith space so that you can expand. We're gonna take one last card in this reading. It's all about the divine feminine. It's all about the energy, the emotion. It's all about the subtlety of following that vibration and getting more and more in tune with it. The last card for this reading that comes out is called Playtime. And when we say playtime, it's really playing the instrument of your personal body, allowing yourself to be playing in the light, swimming underneath that sea of emotions, going down into the depth of the subtleties of all of our intricate vibrations, and knowing that that light is guiding us, as you can see up top here. It's also about playing looser, playing in a way that allows us to become more childlike because we are letting go of logic and reason. We are taking those risks, being a little, not foolish, but being a little awe and wonder struck so that we can expand and grow and play bigger in this world. This is just a season for the expansion of the light in you, and that's what this first reading was all about. Now, go ahead and stick around for reading number two. If you're inspired to, you'd be surprised at how it plays in for your personal circumstances. In any case, subscribe to this channel. You can always set an intention to be led to another video reading on my channel and then just watch those. So here we go. We're gonna get right into reading number two. Now, if you're just joining us, remember, you can always go back after this and watch reading number one if you're inspired to. And the best way to start this reading is to make the intention that it's for you, that divine timing is all there is, you're in the right place at the right time. Then you can just relax, take that deep breath, hold it in a little extra long so that you can go into that quiet space where there's no emotion and no words, where you're a blank canvas ready to receive. And decide that you're only going to receive what is for your highest good in this reading. Let's get started. First card that comes out in this reading is called Speak Your Truth. Oh, now look, this is a very refined, divine, masculine reading. This means that we have been through so much and that we have collected all of that emotion, all of that heart-filled experience, and we want to watch ourselves experience all of the sharing of that as butterflies. What does that mean? That means that we've matured, that we have hard-won experience that nobody else has, and that we want to be sure to articulate that in a simple, clear, confident way, speaking your truth. This little blue round throat chakra light is just showing that we have all been through these caterpillar to butterfly experiences, and we have experience that other people don't have that they could use. So be mindful, be conscious, be ready to be on this green spiritual heart and be sharing very succinctly and very matter-of-factly your blossom experiences that you've been through as of late. Now, some of this stuff could come up from past memories. Some of this stuff will feel like, wow, this person's put in my life for me to share this bit of information with them. It'll be very obvious, very clear of these times where you ought to speak your truth. Now, the other thing about this is that whatever you truly hold as valuable for your own self, protect that. And not like someone could hurt it or harm it. When I say protect it, it just means look up, not at them. That's why she's looking up in the card. Look up and be willing to stand for what you sense is the best, the right, the highest stuff. And you can say it to other people in this very gentle butterfly wings that are floating type of a way. Meaning, use your words slowly, use them confidently, use them matter-of-factly, not to convince other people, but just to express, to press out, to imprint your truth on the canvas of your personal life in all of your interactions with people and situations around you. So it's showing that you do have the authority as that divine masculine within you. We all have the divine masculine and the divine feminine, meaning the words and the vibration or light or emotion. The words and the emotion go together to form a spearhead of renewal in our personal lives as we speak our truth in spite of what other people think or don't think. We don't have to argue with them. We don't have to convince them. We just simply express it. This is a mature state of being where we are able to go up into that space up here, our third eye space, get with our light and bring those flowers of truth down into the world of our personal life. We're protected by all of our spiritual body. That's what all the chakra colors are around her head here. There's nothing against us except our own words, our own beliefs. So we want to build the highest beliefs that we know into the world by speaking our truth. This mature state of being is only going to help to give us a lot more peace. You can see it in the card as she's just relaxed. And it's going to bring the white light down into our personal life in a way that is beautiful. More and more, you're going to see that just by relaxing and speaking your truth of what you sense, of what you know, of what you've experienced, that's going to be the authority in your life that nobody can really argue with. Now, they might not buy into it, and that's okay. The important thing is that you express it, because what you express out there is what comes back to you. The next card in this reading, this is reading number 2. Now, you can always go back and watch reading number 1. Surrender. Surrender the idea that you can fix someone. That's what we were just talking about. As we are this green heart chakra with our arrow, there it is, our arrow of red to expand our material world, but the root chakra red arrow, we aren't going to try to convince other people. We don't have to. We just present the information and we relax and let go. And in this way, we are shaping our own life. We are hitting the mark with our arrow. We are living spiritually. That's why the card is all green. And we don't have to feel any of that panic or any of that desperation or any of that control over people, places, and things around us. It's a very emotionally mature and mentally mature situation that we're moving into. As strong adults who are spiritual beings, shaping our own life, living true, speaking our truth, being that green heart chakra incarnate. You can see it in the card. And here she is. Beautiful. Now, we've let go of fixing other people. We know everybody's on their own path. We know that as we speak our truth in a very non-threatening, but just a very, very matter-of-fact way, that we are expanding that for ourselves. And if anybody else can pick up something worthwhile from it, they'll grab onto that too. Because remember, everything is happening in divine timing. Let's take the next card. The realization of our truth is going to come back towards us. We're going to be living in this new root chakra field, represented by all the red and pink clouds. This is going to be the realization of what we're saying, of the essence and the power of what we're speaking, is all going to come back and color the skies and the details of our personal life in a bigger way. So there's nothing that can keep the good from what you are sharing from coming back to you. If you just accept that there's nobody to convince, that it's all just a flow and an expression of information that goes into your personal life based on your words and your acceptance of God, Source, Universe, manifesting, making real the things that you would have in your life by what you articulate. So continue to speak your truth so you are able to watch that become real in your own life in a bigger and bigger way. All of this equates to a sense of well-being, a sense of independence, a sense of authority over your personal life. Fears are falling away because we know there's nothing against us. There couldn't be an enemy. Let's look at the last card in this reading. It comes out to be, stay optimistic. That is going to be us keeping our eye on the Green Heart Chakra prize. You can see the whole field is Green Heart Chakra and the castle is up there on top of it. This is us going the distance, staying positive, speaking the truths we want to see manifested. Not just sharing the truth of like negative things, but also sharing the bigger picture, so that we can see the whole thing and share what we really want to keep and have realized and reflected back in our personal life. Remember, we are building a castle on top of our green heart chakra. That castle is our personal life. And that comes from the words we share, the things that we hold to be true, and that we express to other people in the world, not to convince them, but just to press out there and write on the canvas of life. So stay optimistic, meaning pick the best things that you really want to see. Look for ways how your life is really working out and then describe that. That way you're going to be bringing all of that bright light and all of that structure of the things you want to see realized in your life. Use your words wisely. Use them for the good. One last card coming out of this reading. It's a bonus card. Now, after this reading, you can go back and re-listen to it or watch reading number one, or you can set the intention to be led to a different video reading on my channel and then watch that. Here we go. Here's your last bonus card for this. And it's the exhaustion card. Why? Because it's a little bit of empathy for us. We know that living in the world is exhausting. We know living as a personal self can be difficult. It doesn't always look like this beautiful, svelte, well-oiled machine of being able to intuitively know what to do every moment. Sometimes it looks like we've gotten a little beat up. Sometimes we're just weary. And when that happens, just know that you're still wearing your green heart chakra. You can see it on the bandana and you can see it on the armband. This is us relaxing back, going back into this space and allowing the stars, you can see it in this alien right here, allowing the stars, the spirit, the angels, the source, whatever you want to call this other dimension of life that is helping us, we allow that to be overarching and watching over us as the landscape will eventually change. So relax. If you're tired, take a break, but just know you are that green heart chakra incarnate. Enjoy. Thanks for being a part of this pick a card reading. Go ahead and give me some comments below. We'll rewatch the video. Subscribe to the channel. Like the video. If you're willing to do all that, it helps the algorithm for this video and for the other videos on my channel. Thanks for being a part of all of this. I'll see you again. Take care. Goodbye.